Hello everybody, it's Just Plain Ken again, giving you another action figure review. This time it's going to be Rey from The Last Jedi, Episode 8 of Star Wars Skywalker Saga, and this is from the Vintage Collection. So there she is. Let's go ahead and let's start off with the card back. And as you can see here, my figure came in disarray. I mean, this is probably the worst package I've probably ever got from a figure. Probably next to my Spawn movie version of Clown. Well, that was a really bad one. So it's all bent up and folded. And of course, this was like taped up. So, but the figure itself is totally fine. And that's what I care about. So, again, this is Star Wars, The Last Jedi. This is Vintage Collection. We have Kenner here. And on the back is the other figures in the last line, not this line. Well, he's from this line. And I believe, not her, she was, I think these three are from the last line. This is from the current, no, she was from the last line too. Well, shoot, I don't know. It's really hard to tell which wave of which this one is. So, and of course this is VC-122. In case you're wondering, and this is Star Wars The Vintage Collection, which I absolutely hate the name, The Vintage Collection, because these aren't vintage at all. These are modern figures. So, enough about the packaging. Let's focus on the Jedi in training Rey. Or as they say on the package, Rey Island Journey, which really wasn't a journey because she didn't go anywhere. So, I can tell you right now, she looks good. I mean, just from, you know, how she looks, she definitely looks like Daisy Ridley from the movie, and the outfit is screen accurate for the most part. However, her... got a little thing stuck in here. However, this poncho... it looks really not so good. I mean, I'm glad. I'm very, very glad. Don't get me wrong. I'm super glad that this is soft goods. But I tried this earlier, and you can't get her hood because of, I guess, her hairstyle here. But you can't get the hood over her head because this is a kind of a rubber band here, or this is a band, a stretchy part here, so you can take it off, that's no problem. But trying to put the hood over her, it's like, it ain't gonna happen. It just ain't gonna happen. I mean, you look at how it's made. It's like, you can tell, like, you see that? Like, you can't put that over her head. You can't put that over her head. And it really looks like, I mean, you look at it and you're just like, you know, this is not... This was not made to be as great as it could have been. I mean, I don't know. Maybe, of course. I mean, this is how it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be flopped back because this is the picture in which they give her. See, it's supposed to be flopped back. And in that way, I guess yes, okay, it's fine. But I mean, it should have had a comparable hood. I mean, it should have. But without the soft good poncho, you can look at her and she looks really good. Let's go ahead and let's go into a comparison between her and Jedi Training Rey from the basic line, which I do have. So, and you can see right away, I mean, the face sculpt is better. Obviously, it's better. Okay? And yes, the outfits are different, but I'm just comparing the faces. I mean, this is the best looking Rey in the basic figure that I have. And of course, these are both standing, you know, they're relatively the same size. They're 3 3/4. But yeah, like I said, the face sculpt alone is definitely much better. Okay, so let's go ahead and put her away. And let's go ahead and take a look at her articulation. So the arm can go up that far, it can go down, it can turn 360. She has bendable, ooh gosh, that's always scary. She has, yes she does, she has, oh wait, hold on, Ah, okay. It was backwards. She does have a 90-degree bend on the elbow. And her head is... Oh, yeah. It's on a bald joint. She can look down. Oh, that looks nice. She can look up a little bit. She can turn left. She can turn right. She can do that little, bend, which I like. I like that bend for some reason. She has... Oh, she does have waist rotation. Her legs can go out that far because of the mold here. And they can, there is thigh rotation. Okay. And she can move her leg up a little, about that far. Not really that much. She can move it back that much. Again, partly because of the rubbery part of her shirt there. She does have a knee bend. Yes, that one's stuck. Oishua. Ah, there we go. So there's knee bend here. So you can see that. And there is also knee rotation. And if you look very closely, there is ankle bend about that far. And an ankle bend about that far. Now that's a good bend. I like that. See, unlike the Galaxy of Adventures, this is perpendicular. This isn't like they don't have the thing on the side there. And of course, there is ankle rotation, but there is not ankle tiltage on this, and I like that. That's cool. That's good. That's very positive. So, that's gonna be it for the figure. Let's go ahead and let's switch to the accessories. Now, of course, this is Rey from The Last Jedi, and she comes with her, well, not her lightsaber, but she comes with Anakin/Luke's lightsaber. And again, it is the standard lightsaber, but for comparison's sake, let's go ahead and take a look at one from the basic line. Right here, we can see here. And yeah. There's paint application. There's more paint application. There's a slightly bit more. Let's go ahead and get closer in there. There is, this one's actually a little bit more detailed. I mean, you can see right there. Like, you can see grooves in there. Ooh, man, that's kind of... I mean, there is better paint applications, but then you also have this hook here. But this one's a little bit bigger. And then you can see grooves in here, but not in here. But these parts are painted. So, interesting. And, of course, they're clear... plastic, blue plastic, you know, whichever you take for it. So, I don't know. Which one do you think is better? Do you think this is better for the detail, or do you think this is better for accurate size and paint application? You decide. All right, and of course, don't want to get that mixed up here. She comes with her trusty little blaster here. Again, I think this is the same blaster as the basic collection. It doesn't, there's no real big, I mean... This is painted, so I'm pretty sure that the basic one, this is not painted at all. But I think it's pretty much the same one anyway. They just painted this black. So, focus, there you go. So, yeah, that's probably the only difference. So, other than that, that's it. That's what you get. So, that is Island Journey Rey from The Last Skywalker Vintage Collection. And, of course... She does have a little holster, much like the basic. The basic line also has a holster there, so they don't look all that different. Yeah. Okay, and to prove my point, I can actually take this and I can probably put it in this one too. Yeah, see. Ooh. Just barely. Huh. So, I guess maybe this is actually bigger? Maybe they aren't different. I'll have to do a comparison on the blasters, and I'll Twitter it, or I'll Instagram it and show you just to see what. But other than that, I think the face sculpt is better. I like the extra articulation. She looks good. I don't have this one in the basic line, so I'm really happy to get this one. I really like this design. I like her jacket. And overall, I like it. I like it a lot. So this is just plain Ken saying to all you guys, girls, and collectors out there, find it, grab it, play with it. May the force be with you. Dun, 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 dun,